One of the important questions that patients ask me is about applying something local to the area where a breast biopsy has been done, or to an area where a lumpectomy has been done, or any sort of surgery to the breast, or for that matter, elsewhere within the body. And so the question becomes cold versus heat. In the short term, generally 24, certainly 48 hours or so after surgery, cold is the better thing to apply. As a good example, when we do core biopsies with either ultrasound guidance or stereotactic guidance, patients are often provided with one of these little ice packs that freezes up when you put it in your freezer, apply it. So cold not only numbs the area, it constricts the blood vessels a little bit, which should help with the swelling that comes from any surgery. Think about a good example in your own life. What if somebody bopped you in the eye and you were getting a swelling? Would you want to apply cold or would you want to apply heat? You'd want to apply cold because you want the blood vessels to constrict. You want to sort of numb the area. Conversely, if you apply heat to a newly injured area, what it's going to do is actually dilate up the blood vessels, make the swelling in the area worse. As the swelling becomes worse, the pain increases and you're in a vicious cycle that you don't want to be in. So certainly for the first 24, 48 hours, maybe even up to 72 hours after any kind of surgical procedure, think cold, not heat. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.